So we're not going to cover the complete portion. Miss some classes and just much slower compared to the offline live class. The beginning of the response was also very slow, so could not complete. Had to go very slow in my opinion. Starting a question, so I thought I'd spend more time there. Okay. If it's a scheduled questions, you can read up on your own. Because there is a lot of mathematics here, which that. Okay, so distribution. Okay, so May 8th is an important event. Machine vision. So Google got the first self-driven car license in history. So the future, perhaps, we may not need drivers. So cars will drive themselves. So how is that possible? So machine vision is important. That. The number of sensors are there. Okay, so that is the potential of machine vision. Because now in India also there's a lot of work going on. So we have drones and all, which is are used to attack. So there's a company in Pune which is doing a lot of work in that area. IIT Madras also they have a project on that. Drones and producing machine vision. So there's a number of technologies, not purely mechanical, it's not purely computer science. So all people have to get together to make this reality. Okay, so we learn what is machine vision. So that is defined as the process of extracting, characterizing, and interpreting information from images. So this is the definition of machine vision. Okay, in the book by Gonzalez. So, machine vision generally consists of six steps. First step is sensing, which is a process that reads a visual image. So, sensing camera is required to capture the information about light up and down. And that is stored in the file. Nowadays, of course, we have digital cameras and digital analysis of the data. Then after getting the image, the first step is pre-processing. So this is to reduce any noise. Sometimes there may be vibration in the camera. So then by averaging the number of images, we can eliminate some of the vibration. The best position of each point can be determined. Enhance the details. Sometimes you want to find out only a small portion in the image. So from satellite imager, you have to find out location of a house. So you have to enlarge it and identify the particular. Then segmentation. So here we divide the image into objects of interest, partitions. So which is what? Drone. So it has to see which are the tanks, which are the infantry men. So the tanks have to be neutralized. So we divide into objects of interest. So these three steps, we call it the low level revision. So this is mostly hardware oriented. And after the segmentation, so once you identify what are the things and the area, objects in the, you don't identify the object as it is, but some areas of interest, that is studied in detail. The next stage, which is high level vision. So description, computation of features to differentiate objects. So it is just like how we recognize people or how we describe people. So he's a tall person, tall, thin person. So similarly, we compute parameters of the object, what is its length, width, etc., and describe. So each object can be described using a number of parameters. Then, once you describe, so we have several objects. So we compute the various parameters of the object, length, width, etc. Now we have to witness, is it a person, or is it a tank, or is it a ship? Then, finally, we have to interpret. So we have got a number of images. So we have identified the building. Now there are tanks nearby. There are some vehicles nearby. So if you identify the vehicles as tanks, then we know that that building must be a military establishment, and we can attack that building. But sometimes, after attacking, we realize that it is a hospital, and the vehicles were all ambulances. So such things happened recently in Afghanistan also. The U.S. general apologized to the people for having attacked innocent people and killed some people. The same thing had happened 7 years back in the Iraq war also. So this is one of the problems, interpreting the various images. It's not so easy. So this part is high-level vision, so more of a intelligence. So now we come to the common industrial applications of machine vision. So we can divide into gauging, presence verification, identification, character recognition, and print quality inspection. So this is the classification by demand. Okay, here's on industrial machine. So classification is so gauging is basically measurement. So this book emphasizes the metrological part more. This. So we'll see an example of how gauging is done. So gauging example. So the aim is to determine center distance between the bolts and the punched part. So side panel of a car radio. So this is again an example from Germany. Volkswagen or something. So generally, the philosophy of German car Japanese car makers is different. So German makers, they always want to inspect and ensure quality. Whereas Japanese, they ensure the quality by the processes. They don't do inspection. So they are prepared inspections. So that's why this machine technology was developed mostly by German companies. So you can see the images here in this example. And of course, now we have this for so many other differences. So the center distance between poles needs to be measured. So the press tool is producing large number of parts, so you have to inspect a large number of parts. That's a different. So the steps are image capture, define region of interest, entire image, determine threshold, create region of interest by thresholding, entire panel. So what is the what with the piece we have to identify? Determine the distance between two poles. So this is the image captured, calculations, determination of hole center, average of all points, determine center distance. Robust method of determining center distance. Result times 80 milliseconds plus the capture time and 8 milliseconds the calculation time. Of course, now it is the computers have become really fast. This is several years back, so it's not a computers have become much faster now. But at that time, a big computers were slower than the now. Second is presence verification to verify that something is present. For example, this is again an example from MicroBot, so German company. So in the spark plug, If you have purchased a smart watch or you have seen old smart watch, there are not sufficient markers. But these markers can never be removed. So that is to fix the length of the position of this spot gap. So that is fixed. So this cannot be removed. So to check if washers are present, we need so you have to inspect a large number of spark plugs. So differently, you are separating washers from product base. So you have to measure the differentiate between the washer and the base. For the eye, it's easy, but very difficult for the vision system without accessing the structure knowledge. We have to recognize the washer that is not see. It's a thin one. So instead, different the engineers come up with a different solution. Simply check the total length of the part that including the washers. So if washers are present, length will be more. Otherwise, length will be less. So measure the combined thickness. So this thickness is measured. And if these washers are missing, the thickness will be less. So the steps in the process are align the object, identify such lines, first dot pixel, last dot pixel, shows the length. So between these two, we get the length and decide whether the part is the washer is present or not. So similarly here, during the assembly, people used to forget to put screws. So how do we check whether screws are present? So, first one of the object is fixed, identify the pixel first, verify the brightness to verify that the screw is present. So, screw either screw may be missing altogether or the screw may be present but not tightened. So, unfastened screw is very bad. So, if it is missing, it is totally black. If it is unfastened, it's not gone into the fully depth, then it will be reflecting more light, so it will be more bright. So these are all examples of defective assemblies. That's the system of it to identify the presence of screws in. Okay, so with that, then, okay, next we come to identification. So I don't know whether you can recognize this. In the olden days, this used to be very common. This is a film roll. And film roll used to come with various speeds. The sensitivity of the film can be low, high, or medium. So there used to be an ASI number, American Standard Substitution ASI. So even now, ISO 400, etc., if you see in a mobile phone, if you are interested in camera settings, you can set the ISO number in the camera. So for low light conditions, they automatically boost the ISO of the sensor. So a lot of changes have been happening in this photograph. So, okay, this film, after taking the photos, they have to be developed. So Agfa, they established a large facility for developing these films. And the films have to be sorted into based on the sensitivity, because each sensitivity film for different times. Chemicals are almost same, but the fine grains. So usually the slow films are used for portrait photographs and all, and there the grains should be very fine. So they are very slowly in low concentration chemicals. The high ASI films have photos taken in generally for photos taken in low light conditions. So there it has to be developed in fast so that and for a long time so that the low light grains also get developed. So the challenge was to inspect 20 rolls per second because they were getting back the films. All the photographers were sending back the films to the studio, and the studio will do the developing. So of course, this is a large plant. And they had to inspect 20 rolls and sort into various film speeds. So the standard video camera can capture at the rate of 25 or 30 frames per second. Even on your videos and all, if you see the frames per second, it is around. So either 25 or 30 frames per second. So non-optical methods are possible. You can incorporate some magnetic something sensor on the film, etc. That is also possible. But which is the cheapest and best method? That is the what engineer has to say. Engineer has to see economics also. Okay? It is not just technical. It has to be economically implemented. So what is the best method? So that's what ACFA thought, and they came up with this. Engineers. As I said, Germany is, they have a lot of interest in machine vision. So they are always doing for such methods. So they used an asynchronous reset camera. So that means it is not, time is not fixed. It is asynchronous, it can take any time. It is reset, so after taking this reset back, and then next time when it is triggered, it will take. So the capture is started by a trigger signal. So you have to have some way of triggering the camera when only the photo. Short exposure time to avoid blur. So the films were moving on a conveyor belt. So if you use a long exposure time, by the time you take the photo, the film roll would have moved slightly. So that will cause shake. So you can see in low light, if you take a photograph of a moving object, many times you may get camera shake, the object is blurred. So to avoid that blur, we have to use short exposure time that requires perhaps a brighter light or a more sensitive sensor. High intensity illumination using a strobe light was used, a flashlight. So this is the setup. So films are placed on the conveyor belt. So there is a light barrier. When the film crosses the light barrier, it triggers the circuit, and after a certain time, the camera takes a photo. By the time the film would have moved and reached in front of the camera, and the light is provided by the strobe light. And the captured image is taken to the PC for analysis. So the analysis, the front edge is chosen as a reference. Region of interest fixed with respect to edge. Resampled to produce data. And neural networks are used to recognize the block codes. So the code for the different films were sort of blocks squared on the outside of the film can. So these blocks, so they were, photographs were resampled. So instead of high resolution, the resolution is reduced. And then, okay, this is all based on the image of that, we could recognize. See 100 ASA, 200 ASA, or 400 ASA. So this is how ACFA could implement this segregation of films using machine vision. And of course, the big problem was how can you do it fast? So identification was taking 10 milliseconds, 40 milliseconds for image caption transfer to PC. So this is actually some 20 years back case study. Now technology, computers at all, in fact, cameras also improved very much. Developments are occurring very fast. So many companies are coming, so many are going out. So, and of course, the mobile phone has become another camera. So now everybody has a camera. Whereas when we were students, very, very few people had camera. So nobody used to take photographs. So photographs are. The world has changed so much. Okay, so that is identification, how to identify films. Next is character recognition. So that is simply, now of course you are all very familiar, if you have done, use the scanner and convert it to OCR, you would have done this several times. But of course those days it was a big issue. Then print quality inspection. Of course, after the Google Lens and all, they do that. You write on your mobile phone, convert it into letters. Then print quality inspection. How to inspect the quality of printing press. So that's another application. So this is slightly old, but I think principle wise it is. So IC inscription view. So IC was used in airbag controllers So 100% inspection was necessary to verify that the correct IC is used. So ICs are assembled into the automobile. So there, again, I think Bosch is a company which makes these airbags and all. So again, a German company. So different models of cars require different designs of airbag controllers, and which IC is used, you need to have a record. So that in future, if something happens, you have to identify whether the correct IC was used or which IC did not work properly. If the airbag did not function, again, we have to identify and take action. So we have to have the traceability. So we need to have a record of which IC is used, which make, etc., in which car. So each airbag controller, and of course, which airbag controller is used in the car, that is with the car manufacturer. So circular illumination using polarized light. So we have to look at the letters are there printed on the ICs. Unfortunately, the printing quality was not good. That was the problem. So in order to get that pre-processing enhancement to compensate for print quality variation. So printing of ICs, what happens is after some time the ink gets dried up, then the printing numbers printed on the IC are not very clear. So it becomes difficult to identify the or read the letters. So this is the IC part, the where the numbers are written. So maybe batch number, serial number, all these are there. Then this is again print quality. Okay, that is this is the view after segmentation, and these numbers are right. So details here. The next is print quality inspection. So another application. So here, so the name, the scale of the fuel gauge is to be inspected. So these are making large quantities. So here you can see that some dot is there, an unnecessary dot is there. So it should be get rejected. And litter LTR should be there, that is also missing. So the procedure, create a reference image with respect to a reference image. So the correct scale will create an image and find out the differences of that with respect to the current image. And that can be used to determine. So simple difference image. A difference image will determine, find out the difference in intensities between each pixel. So that will result in like this. So now there's some displacement in the preference. That's where there is a double image like thing there. So you have to align this. Pseudo errors because of misalignment. So you need some algorithm for aligning the two. So after three-stage positioning, the defects are directed. So R is missing, extra dot is there. So some line is missing there, or that defects have been detected using machine. So this is the textbook which I follow. So Fu, Gonzalez, Sandy, Robert Hicks. So Robert Hicks, Control, Sensing, Wisdom, and Intelligence. So wisdom part alone. So there are two chapters in this book on wisdom alone. So my presentation is mainly based on that. But of course, this is an old book, so there have been a lot of developments. So I have updated some chapters, especially the hardware part. There have been a lot of changes. Some additional material, hardware and storage, also some additional material I have. Chapter 7-8 will be the condensed slot I used to follow. This semester we have missed, and we lost one or two more classes are required to completely cover in full detail. Okay, so.